Hi friends, welcome to biologyexamsforyou.com. Today's topic of our discussion is third line of defense of immune system. At the end of the discussion, you will be able to understand what is the third line of defense, what are the salient features, what are the basic mechanisms, B lymphocytes, T cell dependent and T cell independent pathways, then T lymphocytes, how it works in third line of defense. Even though it's a challenging topic, I will try my level best to make it as simple as possible. Let's begin with the definition of third line of defense. Third line of defense of immune system involves specific strategies to eliminate pathogen either by employing B cells that produce antibodies or T cells that regulates cell-mediated immunity. The key players in third line of defense are T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes, which is assisted by antigen-presenting cells. Antigen-presenting cells includes macrophages, dendritic cells, and B cells. The salient features of third line of defense is, first one is diversity. It can respond to millions of antigens or antigenic determinants or epitopes. And the specificity is absolute. Each antibody is directed specifically against an antigenic determinant or epitope. Then, in third line of defense, there is immunologic memory. Immunologic memory is mediated by memory cells that is produced during immune response. If the same pathogen comes for the second time, memory cells will recognize the pathogen easily and the clearance will be rapid and quick. These are the properties that distinguishes third line of defense from first and second line of defense. First of all, let us discuss the basic mechanism of third line of defense. So this is a macrophage. Macrophage is an antigen-presenting cell. A microbe or a pathogen that is engulfed by the macrophage and that is degraded inside. Then that is presented on MHC class II receptor. And this is the most important point. The degraded particle of the pathogen is presented on MHC class II receptor. Antigen presenting cells has both MHC class I and class II receptor. These T helper cells can recognize only antigenic particles that is bound to MHC class II receptor. On activation, these T helper cells secretes interleukins that stimulates T helper cells further and also stimulates the production of B cells, which later differentiates to form antibodies that is specifically directed against this epitope or this pathogen. It can also recruit cytotoxic T cells that can directly interact with the pathogen and causes the lysis or destruction of infected cell or that pathogen itself. We will be moving into the detail of these interactions later. This is a basic mechanism by which third line of defense works. The players are B cells and T cells along with the assistance of antigen presenting cells like macrophages, dendritic cells and B cells. First, let us see how B cells works in third line of defense. There are two methods by which B cells works. First one is T helper cell independent activation. The antigen that induces this type of activation is called as thymus independent antigen. Often this antigen is having identical epitopes just like this. As you can see, these epitopes are same and that can cross-link the receptor, causing the activation of B cell directly without the involvement of T helper cell. And the second pathway is T helper cell dependent activation. Here B cells acts as antigen presenting cell. It will degrade the pathogen and present a particle of pathogen on MHC class II receptor so that T helper cells can recognize this pathogen and take up the case further. Here, as you can see, these thymus dependent antigens are often having different epitopes which are of different shapes. Let's move into the detail of this pathway. First one is TH cell independent activation. So this is a naive B cell. Naive B cell is a B cell that hasn't encountered an antigen before. Many B cells that is in the circulatory system with different specificities, So each B cell is having an MHC class 1 receptor that is present in all nucleated cell and MHC class 2 receptor that is only present on antigen presenting cells like B cells, macrophages and dendritic cells. So there are B cell receptors also. B cell receptors are often antibodies, monomeric IgM and also IgD. So there are different B cell receptors on the system with different specificities. So T helper cell independent activation by thymus independent antigen like lipopolysaccharide that will bind to the receptor with that specificity. Here this naive B cell 1 is having a receptor that has specificity towards this lipopolysaccharide. So this B cell 1 is activated. On activation, this B cell undergoes clonal selection, or it is selected to divide. Many B cells with that specificity is formed. Later, these B cells differentiates to form plasma cells, and these plasma cells secrete antibodies. As you can see, it will produce millions of antibodies into the circulatory system that can directly interact with the antigen that causes its stimulation. So this will bind to the antigen, either neutralize it or causing agglutination, or antibody bound antigen is often taken up by macrophages and it will be cleared out by phagocytosis. So this is TH cell independent activation. Now let us see what is happening in TH cell dependent activation. In TH cell dependent activation, B cell acts as antigen presenting cell. The antigen, the pathogen is taken inside, then it is degraded and a pathogenic particle is presented on MHC class 2. Now B cell is acting just like antigen presenting cell. Once the antigenic peptide or antigenic determinant or epitope is bound to MHC class 2, T helper cell can recognize this antigen. So T helper cells bind to MHC class 2 bound antigen. Then there are many co-stimulatory signals like CD40, B7, etc. And these co-stimulatory signals are also activated, causing the activation of B cells further. Then cytokines are synthesized by T helper cells that triggers the formation of cytokine receptors on activated B cells. This further activates B cells to undergo division and differentiation. Then the pathway is the same. This B cell is activated, it undergoes clonal selection, it divides and forms many B cells with this specificity. The most important difference is here, memory B cells are also synthesized in the case of T helper cell dependent activation. Immunologic memory is also ensured in this process. Then this B cell differentiates, forming plasma cells. Plasma cells produces antibodies, and antibodies will bind to the pathogen or antigenic determinant, ultimately causing its clearance, just like T helper cell independent pathway. So the most important difference between T helper cell independent activation and T helper cell dependent activation is the formation of memory B cells. And T helper cell dependent activation is more effective, and as memory cells are produced when the same pathogen comes for the second time. These memory B cells recognize the pathogen very easily, and the response will be very quick and it will clear the pathogen soon. These are the two pathways that is mediated by B cells. Now, how T cells works in third line of defense? T cells include T helper cells, which can be called as the commander of the immune system, mediating all other cells, activating all other cells, regulating the entire immune system by recruiting different types of cells, by activating different types of cells. The most important point is antigen-presenting cells can only interact with these T helper cells, as this antigen-presenting cells is having MHC class 2 receptor. Only the antigen that is bound to MHC class 2 receptor is recognized by these T helper cells. Then the second class is T cytotoxic cells. As the term indicates, these cells can directly interact with the pathogen, causing killing of that pathogen or causing destruction of that pathogen directly. The difference is these TC cells can interact with MHC class 1 bound antigen. So cells which is infected or which is having some stress signal will present pathogenic particle or antigenic peptide on MHC class 1 circulating cytotoxic T cells can directly interact with MHC class 1 bound antigen causing the destruction of the infected cell. And we'll be discussing that pathway in detail. We have given a detailed video on difference between MHC class 1 and class 2. You can refer that for more. First, let us discuss the direct pathway that is mediated by T cytotoxic cells. So as you can see, an infected cell, virus infected cell or a tumor cell will present the antigen on MHC class 1. It will degrade the antigen and present its own MHC class 1 receptor. Cytotoxic T cells that is in circulation can recognize this pathogen and it will bound to MHC class 1 bound antigen. Then there are many co-stimulatory signals that activates cytotoxic T cells. Then there will be a cytoplasmic reorientation. Many granules are formed inside cytotoxic T cells that contains perforins and granzymes. Perforins creates pores on the infected cell and fuses with the infected cells and creates pores on the infected cell. Whereas granzymes are apoptotic inducers or causing programmed cell death, causing the complete destruction of that infected cell. Now the cytotoxic T cell is again free in circulation. So this is a mechanism by which cytotoxic T cell directly interacts with infected cell or tumor cell. Then there is a second pathway that is mediated by T helper cell. Here an APC, antigen presenting cell, which degrades pathogen and presents it on MHC class 2. MHC class 2 bound antigen is recognized by T helper cells and this T helper cell is activated. It produces interleukins that triggers the production of interleukin receptors on T helper cells that further stimulates the T helper cells. It divides and secretes more and more interleukin 2, so further activates T helper cells. Interleukins triggers the production of interleukin receptors on cytotoxic T cells with that specificity. Then cytotoxic T cells produce more and more interleukin receptors and these interleukins will activate cytotoxic T cells with that specificity, causing its proliferation and differentiation into cytotoxic T cells and also memory T cells. This enhanced response that lead to the proliferation and differentiation of cytotoxic T cells is only with the assistance of T helper cells, or T helper cell dependent pathway can cause the proliferation and differentiation of cytotoxic T cells into effector cytotoxic T cells and memory T cells. These memory T cells are involved in immunologic memory. So in summary, in both the case of B cells and T cells, if T helper cells are involved, the response will be much more effective that causes proliferation and differentiation of both B cells and cytotoxic T cells. That is why we call T helper cell as a key player that mediates, that regulates the third line of defense. Hope you are clear. This is a summary about the third line of defense. If you want to add any more points, please add that in the comment section. Thank you so much for your support. You are with biologyexamsforyou.com. Please subscribe, share and like this video.